think sometimes men can run away from all the emotional
drama?
Stuff. It's like it's overwhelming to them, and they think, well, I just can't keep up with this.
Well,
this is just more than I know how to do.
There's another caveat behind that, and that is that he may do whatever to make it happen, but not in your timeline.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back to the Fascinating Womanhood channel, where we talk about all things that have to do with femininity and building strong relationships. I'm Cherry Lynn, and I'm so excited to be here with Dixie Andelin Forsyth and her husband, Dr. Robert Forsyth. Hi.
Hi.
The subject that we're talking about today is the three main reasons why men pull away. I'm sure you're probably wondering what we mean by that. I think one of the things that we tend to hear a lot from our ladies is, I don't know what happened in my relationship. We just started growing apart. Even the ladies that are dating, he just disappeared. I don't know what happened. It's kind of confusing. It confuses a lot of ladies out there. We want to understand what it is going on with men in these types of scenarios and relationships.
Yeah, it's either dating or married. Because sometimes married women notice their husband is just pulling away. Men pull away for a variety of reasons in a variety of situations. So yeah, dating or married. But if you're married, it's slightly different than if you're dating. The main thing here is understanding men.
All relationships kind of start a little bit out on a fantasy level. You see this attractive or interesting woman, and she sees a guy that looks great. And so there's a little bit of a beginning fantasy. And then you get together and you start to get to know each other and realize that, well, okay, the fantasy is nice, but there's a reality to the relationship. Sometimes people are constantly looking for the fantasy, but reality and getting to know someone well, even with, you know, realizing they have their faults and their little idiosyncrasies, but learning to become together and a couple, to care about each other and take care of each other, that's a neat process. The fantasy's great and maybe doesn't last the way maybe we'd like it to or something, but building a relationship to me is really an amazing, fulfilling, and meaningful thing, you know, over time.
By the way, I think fantasies sound like that's the ideal. The ideal is actually reality that's amazing. The number one reason, and these are not all of the reasons, is need for emotional safety. We thought of things like, if you are dating, you may be moving too fast. A big one is he may be wounded, either from you or from something in his past. It may not have anything to do with you.
His wall of reserve.
And most men have them. Some have very thick ones.
When you're talking about emotional safety, you're talking about like he's in danger somehow in the relationship?
Or in a relationship he's safe. Because as we get to know each other, some of the little chinks in our armor start to show. And I think if a man feels like even at his sort of most vulnerable or most his weakest point, accept him, or in fact maybe even see him as somebody that's great, feels safe with you.
If he feels less safe with you, and you may or may not be aware of anything that happened, because you may not be aware of some of the things you do or the way you have treated him and the way he reacts to it. Because remember, men aren't as in touch with their emotions and they're not as verbal. So it's not like they're refusing to talk about as much as they don't really, they may not even be aware verbally what's going on. They just pull away.
And emotional safety can be any situation, right? It can be dating, it can be engaged, it can be married for a long time. You can have that, men can have that feeling of, I'm not safe anymore, right?
Yeah. Like, let's say he loses his job. Let's say you're married. I'm trying to do, because it's real easy to see the dating ones where he feels unsafe. But let's say you're married, and let's say this is a really tough time, and his wife starts to look at him as a loser. Mm-hmm. He will feel less safe, even though he's doing everything he can, and there's nothing he can do about the world situation.
Okay.
It's a vulnerable time for everybody, because financial safety is one of women's primary needs. So those things are now bumping.
You know, he may feel preoccupied. He's worried about things. Guys tend to go kind of withdraw a little bit when they're worried or when they're stressed. And she may feel lonely and want more attention, and not really knowing why this is all happening, she may become more critical and more not accepting, I guess you could say, or not with him.
That reminded me of something else. When something happens, if he pulls away, it isn't always about the relationship. Sometimes it's about something that has nothing to do with you. Like Bob said, he may be worried about something or trying to figure something out. And his pulling away, you may see as he isn't as interested in me or I'm displeasing to him, when actually it's something completely different. When you're dating, and even when you're married, it could be that he doesn't feel accepted for who he is. And in Fascinating Womanhood, we say acceptance at face value. In other words, the more you date him and know him, and he may feel like you think you look down on him because he doesn't have enough education or the right kind of job or dressing well or whatever it is. There's a thousand things it could be. It could be one of those things, that he doesn't feel accepted. Like you're constantly telling him he needs a different hairstyle. You don't like his clothing, or
stand up straight.
You know, you have bad posture. That's number one. Okay. Number two is you have different goals and different ideas about where you want your life to go. And that could be after and before marriage too. But if you're dating, it could be one of the reasons for that. It could be he's a player and you have to figure that out, because people can present. It's easy to present yourself any way you want, really, temporarily, but it doesn't last. And because the real you always starts to come out. What if he's a player? What if he's not feeling, what if he doesn't feel needed or necessary?
Well, I think women have an amazing ability to make a man feel like he's a great guy. Now, he may not be aware of that, but if he feels like he's a great guy in her eyes, even if he makes some mistakes, but she looks to the better side of him or believes in him, it makes him, just feel like more, he's safer and he's more needed. There's a place for him in a relationship.
Also, trust may have been broken in number two. He may have lost his trust in some way. And there are so many ways to lose his trust, because you have to kind of be, women have to be kind of a detective in their own relationships. We all do. What's going on here? But these are just possibilities. You could be drifting apart because you're not spending any time together.
You know, you probably need, at least probably an hour a day of time that you actually communicate and talk to one another and talk about your day and actually share your feelings and your life with one another. Some people hardly really talk to each other. They kind of just are, ships passing in the dark.
Well, and I love the video that we did on the four levels of relationships. And I think that's where anyone watching that wants to hear more about this specific reason men pull away, I think that's a great video to watch, because it explains how important it is to move your relationship forward and kind of check off certain levels. Going through that would hopefully help you to learn how compatible this person is. And hopefully you would follow that and not find out 5 or 7 years into your marriage that you guys want different things.
So you're not really compatible. Yeah.
Yeah. And I think that's unfortunate now. Like, we have such a high divorce rate, and I'm sure there's many other reasons, but that's one that comes to mind to me.
Women are the ones who are more willing to figure out what's wrong and work on it themselves, because they're willing to verbalize and get in touch with their feelings quicker, and they're able to quicker. If you've lost trust with him, that's a whole thing that you have to work on. And if you're dating someone, you may not know how you lost his trust, because you really are still getting to know him, and you'll have to figure that out. The last one, he just doesn't think you're the one.
I think that's a big one. That's a really big one.
He doesn't think you're the one. And you might say, but why? Because he dated me. We've been dating for 6 months. And some people say, if he wants you, he'll make it happen. That's full of a lot of...
That's tricky.
It's tricky. That is tricky. It isn't always true.
What are some examples of that not being true? Because I think there's a lot of women out there that, like, there's those movies, like, he's just not that into me. And there's this really popular opinion out there right now that if a man's into you, he will make the date happen. He will book the next day. He will pursue you, which is great. We're not saying that men shouldn't be the pursuers, but what are some examples of when that doesn't necessarily play into what's going on?
All men are not the same. That's the bottom line. They're not the same any more than we are not the same. Some men are so wounded or have such poor confidence when it comes to women that they're just not going to do it. They actually want to take it one small level at a time to feel safe. And they appreciate when the woman, they can tell absolutely that she's into them. So you can't make a blanket statement like that and say, all men, if they're into you, they will make it happen.
You know, women, I think, have they're often more aware of and sensitive to relationship things that are going on. And I think sometimes a man can be overwhelmed with relationships. Guys are a little more, maybe more target-oriented, more task-oriented. They're a little simpler in the way they approach things. And for a woman, it's all about the relationship. For guys, it's sometimes a little bit more about tasks that they're doing and something they're accomplishing and feeling competent at. If a woman is really, really skilled at the relationship part of this, I think sometimes men can run away from all the emotional
drama?
Stuff. It's overwhelming to them. And they think, well, I just can't keep up with this.
Well,
this is just more than I know how to do.
There's another caveat behind that. And that is that he may do whatever to make it happen, but not in your timeline. Like, for example, mm-hmm. what if he's really working hard on his career to either go to school or, you know, and he's really focused on that or a promotion or something. Men aren't as good at multitasking. He may make it happen, but not exactly when you think. Some patience may be required. Sometimes we say that some of these things are just excuses. Maybe they are, but maybe they're not.
I have to say, I'm so much more task-oriented. And so if I'm doing something, a lot of distraction or other issues going on make me kind of frustrated because I'm trying to reach something. If you're with someone that's all about the relationship or all about the emotional part of that, I can't do all of this at once. Let me do what I'm trying to do and maybe in a sense accept me as a guy that approaches things quite differently. I don't approach things the way Dixie does. For her, everything's about relationships.
Well, what this boils down to is you have to understand your particular man. And this is, we talk about in the middle section of my book, Understanding Men. You can understand him, but you've got to focus on him. This is a true story. I know somebody, who's absolutely crazy about this girl. That's all he could think about was he wanted to marry her. And he said to people, if I don't marry her, I'll never marry. Problem is, she wasn't that into him for quite a while. So then finally, when she did come around and did decide he's pretty neat, he had kind of given up. And so she started kind of acting interested in him, but he didn't really believe it for a while. And so it seemed like he wasn't all that into her, but in reality, he just didn't want to get rebuffed again. He didn't really believe it. And for a while, she had to go way out of her way, which is what she was not used to. She felt like she was being really forward with him in order to convince him she was interested in him because he had tried for so long and she had just not been interested at all. So you can't make blanket statements like that about all men. But what we are saying is when you read Fascinating Womanhood, especially Fascinating Womanhood for the Timeless Woman, because it has so much more in it, you will begin to understand this particular man, your man, what he's suffered in his life, what his fears are, what his hopes are, what his ambitions are, and you can adapt to that. It'll be easier for you to be patient
and accept him
and not misjudge that he's either not moving too fast. He may be disinterested, and if he is, you got to figure out why. He may not feel accepted. You may have broken trust with him in some way. There isn't just a way that you can just know all men A, B, C.
I love that you pull in kind of a solution because every time we do videos like this, we have a tendency to get comments of, well, now I know this, what do I do? So I think that's great that you're including, well, this is why, the reason why we're doing this video is to, really, this is why all the principles in Fascinating Womanhood are so important. And this is such a great discussion, I think, for a lot of the ladies out there that maybe haven't read the book yet. And they can say, okay, like this is a reason why I might want to read books.
There's a workbook that goes with that. I was looking at the workbook and it's kind of amazing because it gives so many encouraging things you can do. I mean, it's nice to talk about concepts and principles and ideas.
It gives you activities. And
the workbook gives specific, do this, try this, make a list of this. And it gives you things you can do that really have an impact. I really am kind of a fan of the workbook.
As you try to figure it out and you know what areas to look at, You can. You can figure out whether it's you or whether it has nothing to do with you, and it may be him.
Can I ask Dad to share the story about the girl that you pulled away from that was looking at your labels in your clothes?
Yeah, it's been a while, but I remember she would, sometimes she'd come up behind me and she would pull my shirt to see what kind
brand,
of
brand,
what brand of shirt I was wearing, and if it was kind of a cool brand or if it was maybe, you know, maybe a cheaper brand from a cheap store or something like that.
Well, you were telling me this morning there was one girl that would put her hand on your back and say, stand up straight.
You gotta stand up straight, or you're not standing up straight. You know, I don't, it's little things sometimes like that, that where you don't feel like, you know, I'm never going to really be good enough for this person if I don't just wear the right clothes, or if I don't just stand up just the right way, or if I don't wear the right cologne, or, you know, I'll never quite be good enough. I know that the tarnish comes off of a fantasy, but there's a lot of good in each one of us. Now, yeah, there's faults and negatives, but I think Dixie and I have found over the decades that we've been married that we know each other's weaknesses, but we focus more on the positive parts of our relationship, and we build on the positive rather than accentuating the negative.
Yeah, sometimes it's little things like that when you're dating that makes a man just pull away. Remember, most men don't want to marry their mother. They don't want you to.
Yeah.
I always have thought he was the most amazing man ever. And so when he told me about some of these girls he used to date, I thought, I can't even imagine. Did I give a rip what he wore? No. I didn't even think about it.
You like me to take care of myself, though. You said that's one of the things you appreciated.
Well, I appreciated it, but he didn't ever smell bad or things like that. But I didn't care what brand he wore. It didn't even occur to me. Not at all. I just wanted to marry him.
Well, this has been a really great discussion. Thank you both so much for all of your wonderful advice. And if there's anyone out there that hasn't read Dixie's book yet, I'll attach a link below for you to check that out. And we also want to hear from you. Do you have any situations that you want to ask us about with your marriage or with your dating or relationships? Definitely ask the questions down below. We'd love to hear from you. And we're here every week, so don't forget to come back and see us next time. Thanks. Yeah. Bye.
Bye.